So, we're going to have a look at the mission inspiration for February. And I've got to create this. Do I need to create it? I think that's a pretty good colour actually, salmon. We'll use that. So anyway, one of the ingredients is tissue paper and circles. So I'm going to use my jelly plate to create the background, or elements for the background, or something. So, just squirt this on. Get rid of that. Use the brayer. Jelly plate. Lumpy bits, but that's okay. Use this cup. Probably should clean it off a little bit. That's how we use it. Okay. There we go. And I'm going to use this napkin. Hopefully that won't stick too much in it. Let's see. Ooh. Lovely. That's one piece. Pop that over there. Let's see if we've got enough on the brayer. Maybe a little bit more paint. Use other side. I don't mind if it's not perfect, if it's a bit squidgy, it all adds to the texture and the interest. There we go. And that should give me plenty to work with for my background. Wow, I love that. It's like a fabric tie-dyed or something. So I'm just gonna wipe off the or pull off the excess. And then we'll have a bit of a clean up, wait for those to dry, and then we can start creating our page. Okay. I'm not sure what that is flashing on there. Hopefully this is recording. So I'm going to use some clear gesso to glue this down. Let's see. I'm standing up because the cat's sitting on the bed. Right. Oops, this brush is unclean. There we go. Clear gesso. Have to delete some space on there. Delete some videos to make some space for my makeup. Okay. And stick it down. Down to sleep. No, let's get some of the other one. And the reason I'm using gesso is so that when I come to do add some paint in a bit, it's just gonna already be gessoed and an easier surface to work on. I find that matte medium can occasionally cause like create a resist sort of thing. Okay. It's very strange. Earlier I went up to the shops with my mum and we were all wrapped up warm because the wind was bitter. I was wearing my sunglasses because it's very, very sunny. Very strange. Okay, I think just one more piece, two more pieces, and we'll be done with that and let that dry and then figure out which step to do next. I think I'm gonna do a little wash over this with grey because that is one of the other colours in the colour choices. I just want to add a little bit more just to cover up that green spot there. And that hair there. Just add a bit more there. Yeah, the wood pigeons sounds like a beautiful summer's evening, doesn't it? Gosh, I hope we're out of lockdown this summer. We need to come out soon. I think everyone is going to be stir crazy, aren't they? I know I am. Here we go. So I'm going to leave that dry. Yeah. No, I'm not going to dry it with heat tool because it would disturb the cat. And I want him to sleep. So I will see you when this is dry. Okay, so I'm going to create a grey. So wash. Oh, yeah. Just so. I'm a tiny, tiny bit black paint. Black tends to overpower everything. So, just. Too much, so I'm not gonna mix it all in. I'm just gonna grab some of it. Good. And then just grab a baby wipe. Probably not going to spread much on the edges because probably missed it a bit with the gesso. Spread that on. Nice and thin. I concentrate mostly on the white areas first, and then blend in with salmon colors. There's a bit of black on there. So let's get a fresh bit of baby wipe just so we don't contaminate it with the black too much. Oh, and the black's come through now. There we go. Really softened that salmon colour down, which is nice. And again, we'll wait for that to dry. I'll be back with the next step. Okay, so now I'm going to add the numbers and the blue. So let's get some of this. Paint out ultramarine. This paint might be a bit dried up. Let's see what we can do. I need a baby wipe because I don't have any sponges at the moment. I need to get some. A lot of birds tweeting out there. All of a sudden, it's dusk. Suddenly it stopped. How strange. Okay, that's it. Let's have some more here. Just move this book across a little bit so I can get that one in. I like the way some of these numbers aren't, you know, in a different direction than to the other ones. Nice big numbers as well. More here. Yep. Okay. That. Just wipe the stencil off there. So next it is circles and ink. I think I've already done some circles, but I would like to bring some more in. Let's use this, actually, hickory smoke. That's going to bring more of that grey back in. And use the cup again. Let me just go in like this. ice cream in. So, I don't know if I can pick up any of that blue paint now. A little bit. Barely. Okay, so I'm gonna just have that, let that dry a little bit, have a look at the prompts and see what is next. Okay, so last prompt that I'm gonna try that I need to do is make marks. So I'm just gonna add some blue paint to this bubble wrap. Oh, there goes the cat. I'll sit down for a minute then. Okay. That's good. Just want to add just a little bit more of that blue, just so it doesn't stand out quite so much. Look odd, if you know what I mean. Yes, okay, that's enough. And now we're going to add our silhouette. So, ugh, my hands look like paint. I have this Demalts paper doll. And I don't know if you can see, but her face, the die cutting's gone into her face. So I decided to use this one because sometimes the die cutting is a bit rubbish. So it's a good way to use something because they're quite expensive, aren't they? So we're going to use it, and I've painted her black on the back, and she's going to be my silhouette. So let's grab this lovely, well, not lovely, this gel medium. have a spatula. Let's see if this is gonna hold her down nicely. Do we want her in the middle or off to the side or? careful because I don't want to pull the paint off of her. It's just black acrylic paint. And she's slightly shiny on the back as well as the front, so it didn't take the first time I had to do two coats. It took, but it was quite streaky. Okay, and then I'm gonna pop something heavy on her. Do weigh her down. So she doesn't pop up. Probably need a pot of hand sanitizer there. That'll do. So I'm gonna leave that to sit for a little while and then decide what quote I'm gonna use, and then I think we're done. Okay, I think I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to write on here. My own handwriting is very scary. And then I'm just going to write on with this Sharpie pen and then probably go over and make some of the letters thicker with like thicker pens and stuff. So I wanted the quote to be quite bold because we've got her, but she's a very small focal point, so we might as well make the words the focal point. So I'm just going to snip off some of these jaggedy edges. And I just want to grab a pen and just around the figure a little bit. I feel like it needs a border. Hope I don't regret this. Drop my lid, I'll grab that in a minute. feels like there's a lot going on this page, so it needs a resting place for the eye, sort of thing, if you know what I mean. It needs something to bring it all together and show that it is all supposed to be together. There we go. I like that now. Yes, that helps. Okay. Find my lid. Here. Going over to the other side. Okay, so just grab my little pen again. And just pop the date on. February's mission inspiration completed, I think. So, yeah, I think that's quite a poignant page. Quite like that. So, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. And join me again for some more party videos in the future. Thank you for watching again. I'll see you again soon. Bye.